Welcome to this session of Less Than 2 Minutes Job Search Tip. I'm Ramesh Anand. I'm bringing you over 30 years of headhunting experience at a global level, trying to push into 2 minutes. This will run probably over 3 minutes. I'm talking about American phrases, slang, for those who are not exposed to it. Let me hit the ground running with 3 phrases for today. The first one is the number 411. Sometimes at an interview, somebody may ask you, you may say something and they may say, okay, what's the 411? 411 was originally the number one dialed for information. Kids would call if they had a problem with homework and say, what's the 411? They would call and say, I have a problem, can you help me? That has become a phrase. So during an interview scenario, an interviewer, you may say something, the interviewer may ask, okay, what's the 411? Which means that provide me more information, elaborate. The other phrase or word is lemon. I remember many, many years ago when I came to the US, I bought a car and somebody said, oh, I hope it does not turn out to be a lemon because it is not a very expensive car. Lemon is something which is defective, substandard. In an interview scenario, you may be interviewing and an interviewer may tell you that I had a person for this role, turned out to be a lemon, and I now want to make sure I don't find another lemon. And I don't want you to be surprised with the word. So again, lemon is defective, substandard. So you want to make sure that you are not perceived as a lemon, but something way, way, way better and perfect for the job. The third phrase that I have written it here, is hold your horses. I have to tell you where it came from, not very great example, but they say one of the places it came from was the Roman times when somebody had really done something real bad, they would get them trampled by horses. So they would have the person staked on the floor and then they would have horses run over. But sometimes they're still doing the work and the horses are all ready. They would say, hang on, hold your horses. And then once they're done, they'll say, okay, let them go. So that continued, the phrase continued. Even today, it's used very widely. Hold your horses as hang on. You're saying something, you're very excited during an interview and you're continuing. Suddenly the interview stops you and says, hold your horses. Let's go back. What he means or she means is stop talking, wait. Let's go back. Let's revisit something you made a statement about. I want to ask you something about that. So hold your horses can be in any connotation, primarily meaning hang on, wait, please wait, and let's proceed. So again, friends, today I have 3 phrases which are typical American phrases used all over the world multiple times. I've heard it before. For those who are not exposed, one is the number 411, the second is lemon, and the third is hold your horses. Wish you the very best in your job search. There's a button below, subscribe. This is probably the 57th, 58th or 59th episode. It'll continue every day of the working day. You need to reach me, connect with me on LinkedIn. I'll be delighted to respond. If you have a specific question, do not hesitate to send me an email or a message on LinkedIn. Best wishes, keep watching and all the best in your job search.